إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أما بعد، الله عز وجل He tells us in the Quran, in Surah Al-Fatir, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقَّ He says, O mankind, indeed the promise of Allah is true. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا So don't be deceived by the life of this world, the dunya. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ And do not be deceived by al-gharur, يعني الشيطان. Those who explain this ayah in the Quran, they said that the wa'd of Allah, the promise of Allah, it refers to al-ba'thu ba'd al-maut, resurrection. After you die, you're going to be raised up and will meet Allah Azza wa Jal again, يوم القيامة. And as a Muslim, this is something that every Muslim has to believe in. Every single Muslim has to believe in the affairs of the Akhirah. They have to believe in Yawm Al-Qiyamah. One day, the angel Jibreel, he came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the form of a man. فَأَسْنَدَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ إِلَى رُكْبَتَيْهِ He sat right in front of him. He put his legs with the legs of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَوَضَعَ كَفَّيْهِ عَلَى فَخِذَيْهِ He placed his hands on his thighs. And then he asked him a number of questions. Ya Muhammad, he asked him a number of questions. And from that he said, أخبرني عن الإيمان. Tell me about Iman. Tell me about those things that every single Muslim must believe in. He said, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره He said that you have to believe in Allah. You have to believe وملائكته You have to believe in the angels and in the books that he sent down. And you have to believe in the messengers. And you have to believe in the last day. And you have to believe in the qadr of Allah. The decree. فلذلك الله عز وجل he tells us زعم الذين كفروا أن لن يبعثوا قل بلى وربي لتبعثن ثم لتنبؤن بما عملتم وذلك على الله يسير Those who disbelieve in Allah, what do they say? They say أن لن يبعثوا that they're never gonna be raised up again in the hereafter. But Allah says قل بلى say You are definitely going to be raised up. You're going to be raised up in the hereafter. وَلَتُنَبَّأُنَّ بِمَا عَمِلْتُمْ And you're going to be informed about all the actions that you used to do in the dunya. Those who used to do khayr in the dunya, Allah will show them their actions. And those who used to do evil in the dunya, Allah Azza wa Jal will show them their actions. Wallahi, my brothers, barakallahu feekum, this day is coming. إِنَّمَا تُوْعَدُونَ لَآتِ That which you've been promised by Allah is truly gonna come. And that which is important, wallahi, is that we prepare for this day. جَاءَ رَجُلٌ A man, he came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَقَالَ لَهُ مَتَ السَّاعَةِ He said, when is the sa'ah? When is يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ When is this day gonna happen? He said, مَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا He said, what have you prepared for this day? What have you put forward for this day? That's what matters, يعني. What have you put forward for يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ كَيْفَ تُجِيبُ On that day, how are you gonna respond? On that day, يَوْمٌ عَظِيمٌ That tremendous day. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ When they stand in front of Allah. How are you going to answer to him? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, we've forgotten this day. We've forgotten about the hereafter. And we've become busy with the dunya. The dunya has busied us. And Allahu al-Musta'an, you find Allahu Azza wa Jal, he says, Inna ha'ula'i yuhibbuna al-ajila wa yadharuna wara'ahum yawman thaqeelan. He said that these individuals, they love the ajila, the life now, the dunya. Wa yadharuna wara'ahum. They left behind them yawman thaqeela, that heavy day, yawm al-qiyamah. They've left it behind them, Wallahu al-Musta'an. This dunya that in reality has no value. الدنيا الحقيرة is very small, is worthless, it doesn't have any value. The Messenger of Allah said صلى الله عليه وسلم لو كانت الدنيا تعدل عند الله جناح بعوضة If the dunya was equal to the wing of a mosquito with Allah ما سقى كافرا منها شربة ما He would not even give any kafir, any disbeliever water to drink, subhanAllah. The dunya has no value with Allahu Azza wa Jal. But we run towards the dunya. We hasten towards the dunya and we leave the akhirah. Look at the affair of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everybody inside here says Muhammadur Rasulullah. Look at how the Messenger of Allah was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding the dunya. دخل عمر رضي الله عنه على رسول الله. Umar رضي الله عنه, he entered upon the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَإِذَا هُوَ مُطَّجِعٌ The Messenger of Allah was laying down. عَلَى رِمَالِ حَصِيرٌ He was laying on the ground, on straw, يعني, or on the sand. وَقَدْ أَثَّرَ الرِّمَالُ بِجَنْبِهِ The sand, or that which he was laying on, it made a print in his skin. صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَقُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ Umar, what did he say? He said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أُدْعُ اللَّهَ فَلْيُوَسِّعْ عَلَى أُمَّتِكَ He said, make dua to Allah. Umar radiallahu anhu knew that if the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his hands and made dua right now, Allah would answer that dua. He said, make dua to Allah for him to give to your ummah and expand for your ummah. Give them more from the dunya. You're the Messenger of Allah and you're sleeping on the floor. What did the Messenger of Allah say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Or before that, Umar, he said, subhanAllah, he said, فَإِنَّ فَارِسَ وَالْرُومَ قَدْ وُسِّعَ عَلَيْهِمْ He said that Faris, the Persians, وَالْرُوم, the Romans, i.e. these disbelievers, they've been given the dunya in abundance. وَأُولَٰئِكَ لَا يَعْبُدُونَ اللَّهِ They don't even worship Allah. These disbelievers, how many of us today have this mentality? Over there, these kuffar in the UK, in America, in France, in Spain, in these places, they've been given the dunya. And us, وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ We're here. Living in, يعني, as Muslims with the Muslims, we haven't been given anything from the dunya. Look at the mentality. And then the Messenger of Allah said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أُولَٰئِكَ قَوْمٌ عُجِّلُوا طَيِّبَاتِهِمْ These people have been given their reward early. They've been given their reward early, as Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran. وَيَوْمَ يُعْرَضُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا عَلَى النَّارِ أَذْهَبَتُمْ طَيِّبَاتِكُمْ فِي حَيَاتِكُمُ الدُّنْيَا وَاسْتَمْتَعْتُمْ بِهَا He said that the disbelievers, they will be presented to the hellfire and it will be said to them, أَذْهَبَتُمْ طَيِّبَاتِكُمْ فِي حَيَاتِكُمُ الدُّنْيَا Did you receive the goodness and the rewards in the dunya? And then in the akhirah, they're not going to have anything whatsoever. Wallahu al-musta'an. Kadhalika, an Aisha radiallahu anha, the best and most favored wife of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, لَقَدْ كَانَ يَأْتِي عَلَيْنَا شَهْرُ ما نوقد فيه نارا. She said a whole month would go by sometimes and we never lit a fire in the house. بمعنى that they didn't cook anything on a fire. They didn't cook any lahm, any meat, any fish, anything. لا. She said, وَمَا هُوَ إِلَّا الْمَاءُ وَالْتَمَرُ. The only thing we had to eat for 1 month straight was ma and tamar, water and dates. And this is the wife of the Messenger of Allah, صلى الله عليه وسلم. كَذَلِكَ عَبْدُ الرَّحْمَنِ ابْنُ عَوْفِ. طيب, he was from the مُبَشَّرُونَ بِالْجَنَّةِ, those who were given glad tidings of Jannah. In his lifetime, he walked on the earth with the Messenger of Allah and heard, أَنْتَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ, that you're going to be in Jannah. And he was from the Sahaba, the best of mankind ever, radiallahu anhum. And he was ghani, he was very rich, he was rich. And it mentions, utiya bi ta'amin wa huwa kana sa'iman, that food was brought to him but he was fasting. Abdurrahman ibn Awf, he was fasting. Tayyib, the Sahaba, they were ahlul ibadah, people of worship. Even though he knew he was from the people of Jannah, he didn't sit back and relax. He was worshipping Allah outside of Ramadan. He was fasting. So somebody offered him food. And he said, قُتِلَ مُسْعَبْ إِبْنُ عُمَيْرِ. مُسْعَبْ إِبْنُ عُمَيْرِ, who was another companion. He was killed. He was killed in a battle. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنِّي. He said that this man Mus'ab was better than me. And in reality, Mus'ab, he was not better than Abdul Rahman. But this was from his tawadu', from his humility. He said that Mus'ab was better than me. And when he was killed, فَكُفِّنَ فِي بُرْدَةٍ, he was wrapped in a cloth. إِنْ غُطِّيَ بِهِ رَأْسَهُ بَدَتْ رِجَلَاهُ, if that cloth wrapped up his head, his feet would show. وَإِنْ غُطِّيَ بِهِ رِجَلَاهُ, and if his feet were covered, بَدَتْ رَأْسُهُ, then his head would show. Meaning that he didn't even have enough money to pay for the cloth that would wrap him when he died, radiallahu anhu. This is him, subhanallah. وَقُتِلَ حَمْزَ, he said Hamza was killed, radiallahu anhu. وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنِّي, he was better than me. That's what he said. وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِنِّي فَلَمْ يُوجَدْ مَا يُكَفَّنُ فِيهِ. He couldn't, when he died, he didn't even have anything to wrap himself up in, radiallahu anhu. And then he said, وَبُسِطَ لَنَا مَا بُسِطْ. بُسِطَ لَنَا مِنَ الدُّنْيَا مَا بُسِطْ. Abdul Rahman, he said, but we've been given the dunya in abundance. We've been given the dunya, subhanAllah. Look at these individuals. And then he started to cry, حَتَّى تَرَكَ الطَّعَامَ. And then he said, no, I'm not going to eat this food, I'm fasting. He knew the reason why Allah Azza wa Jalla created him in the dunya. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, except to worship him alone. Allah only created us to worship him. But how much do we think about this purpose in comparison to the amount that we think about ad-dunya, ad-dunya, ad-dunya? Wallahu al-musta'an. Allahu Azza wa Jalla, he says in the Quran, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبَقَى. He said that you prefer the dunya. Miskeen, يعني. You prefer the dunya, but the akhirah is better for you. وَأَبَقَى, it lasts forever. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ وَبِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ. الحمد لله وحده, والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده, وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. والله, the dunya has made us blind. نعم, we can see, والحمد لله, but it's as if we are blind, and it's as if we cannot see the reality. Allah عز وجل has prepared for us جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار, and promised us that if we enter, we'll be there خالدين فيها أبدا, we're going to be there forever. But many of us have preferred the dunya. أتستبدلون الذي هو أدنى بالذي هو خير, as Musa said to Bani Israel, have you chose that which is less over that which is better? Allah Azza wa Jal, he gave Bani Israel al-manna wa salwa, this delicious type of food, the best type of food. And what did they say? They said instead they want to eat onions and adas, lentils and garlic and these types of food. Subhanallah. He said, أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدَنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ. In reality, if somebody said today, Subhanallah, لَا بَأْس, I'm going to give you a palace, a castle. طيب, I'm going to give you a whole huge castle. Any car that you want in the dunya, anything. And I'm going to give you all the wealth that you can dream of. Would anybody say, "La, I don't want that. I'm going to stay, you know, in the shop, or I'm going to stay on the street, I'm going to live on the street." Nobody would say this. Everybody would choose Al-Akbar, Wal-Ahsan, that which is better. So why is it that as it relates to the dunya, we give precedence to this, which isn't equal to anything in comparison to the akhirah? Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. The one who turns away from my remembrance, he's gonna have a depressed and difficult life. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. We're gonna raise him up on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ blind. قَالَ رَبِّ لِمْ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدَ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. He's gonna say, Ya Allah, why have you made me blind? When in the dunya I used to be able to see, I could see. يعني, why am I blind now in the akhirah? Allah will say, كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. He's going to say that just like that in the dunya. Our ayat came to you. How many ayat do we read in the Quran about the akhirah and the akhirah and the akhirah? But we forget those ayat. وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. And on that day you're going to be forgotten on يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Blind and forgotten. Why? Because you gave precedence to the dunya and you forgot the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. But on that day in reality, we will truly wake up. Because in the dunya we're busy. Every day we're busy. Busy with the dunya and we don't have time for Allah. Until when? حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ. Until you go to the grave. That day, when Allah Azza wa Jal decrees that your time, it comes. And then somebody or your family, they come, they wrap you up in the cloth and place you in the ground and place the dirt on your body. And you can't do anything else. On that day, you will truly wake up. Naam, you wake up. As Allah tells us about a people, يَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَنَا مَنْ بَعْثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا. That a people are going to say, woe unto us. When they're raised up on Yawm al-Qiyamah, they're going to say, who raised us up? Min marqadina, from our place of sleep. When they see the punishment of the hellfire in front of them, that which Allahul Musta'an, they're going to enter. Why? Because they didn't practice the religion in the dunya and they see the hellfire. It's going to be as if every other difficulty and every other hardship that they faced in the dunya, it's like they were sleeping. مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانِ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. This is what Ar-Rahman promised. Naam. In the beginning we said what? إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌ. Naam, without a shadow of a doubt. If only we gave the same importance to the dunya, that we gave to the dunya. This journey to the akhirah is a journey that we must have, that we must take. يعني, we're going to definitely take this journey. طيب. And in the dunya again, if we had a journey tomorrow, you had to catch a plane. If somebody, subhanAllah, barakallahu fikum, said tomorrow, you have a journey, I'm going to pay for you, you can go to Europe. La, but everybody would prepare. No sleep. You'll pack your bags, get ready. طيب. What about the journey to the akhirah? What about the journey to Jannah? Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادِ التَّقْوَى. He says, prepare. You must prepare. But the best preparation, the best type of isti'dad is for you to have taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. What is taqwa? أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه, he said that التقوى is الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والقناعة بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. He said that التقوى means that you fear Allah. والعمل بالتنزيل, you act upon the Quran. والقناعة بالقليل, you are sufficed with, يعني, with small. You're not one who says, okay, I must have more and more and more of the dunya. وَالِاسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. And you prepare for that day when you're going to meet Allah Azza wa Jal. فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا. Don't be deceived by the dunya. بارك الله فيكم. ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. Do not be deceived by شيطان. طيب الغرور الشيطان. الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. Allah says that شيطان, he threatens you or tells you, يعني you're gonna be poor forever. لا بأس. He also tells you to do evil deeds. This is shaitan. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Don't be deceived by this. بارك الله فيكم. Be patient. طيب, and just before we finish, somebody's going to say, they're going to say, but Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. صحيح, huh? نعم. Allah said, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Don't forget your portion of the dunya. طيب, but what does this ayah mean? Many of those who explained the ayah, they said, لا تنسى نصيبك من الدنيا, يعني don't forget your portion of the dunya, meaning that you use the things that Allah has given you in the dunya to work for the akhirah. وَبَتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكُ اللَّهُ دَرَ الْآخِرَةِ. Strive with that which Allah has given you and use those things for the akhirah. مَا عِنْدَكُمْ يَنْفَدْ وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقَ. That which you have in the dunya is going to come to an end one day. Can anybody say that they're going to live forever? لا أبدا. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بَاقَ. And that which is with Allah will remain forever and ever. Allah says, وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّ الَّذِينَ صَبَرَ وَلَنَجْزِيَنَّ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا أَجْرَهُمْ. Allah says that we are going to repay those who had patience. We're going to give them their reward. بِأَحْسَنِ الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. We're going to repay them for the best of that which they used to do. And finally, wallahi, the Messenger of Allah said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ كَانَتِ الدُّنْيَا هَمَّهُ. Whoever makes the dunya his main concern, always talking about the dunya, فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ شَمْلَهُ أَوْ أَمْرَهُ. Allah is going to make his affairs scattered. He's always confused. What should I do now? He's never at ease, يعني he's never feeling happy and content within his life. وَجَعَلَ فَقْرَهُ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ. And this person who makes the dunya his main concern, Allah will make faqr, poverty, in front of his face, meaning that Allah will give you everything and you still feel like you need more. You always feel like you are poor, faqir. You don't have enough. Subhanallah. وَمَنْ كَانَتِ الْآخِرَةَ هَمَّهُ وَمَنْ كَانَتِ الْآخِرَةُ هَمَّهُ. Whoever makes the hereafter his main concern, أَوْ نِيَّتَهُ جَمَعَ اللَّهُ أَمْرَهُ. Allah will bring his affairs together. This person will always be happy and always be content. وَجَعَلَ غِنَاهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ. And Allah will make this person feel rich within. Allah will make this person feel rich and feel wealthy. وَأَتَتْهُ الدُّنْيَا وَهِيَ رَاغِمَةً. And the dunya will come to this person submissively. Even if this person turns away from the dunya will still come to this individual. Why? Because this person, he lived his life for Allah Azza wa Jal. Al-Razaq, the one who provides. Al-Kareem, the one who is generous. Al-Wahhab, the one who gives. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت وأستغفرك وأتوب إليك وأقيم الصلاة.